Speaking of banks, let's address some of the main earnings that came in today. RBL Bank is on our radar on the back of the Q3 performance. And net interest income growth has been the slowest in the last 5 quarters. NIM performance is quite steady. Net interest margin is at an all-time high at over 4%. The big worry point this time is slippages. Slippages, Abhishek tells us, highest in the last 7 quarters at over 200 crores. So let's get some thoughts in. We have Mr. Ahuja joining us. Thanks so much for taking this call, sir. Good afternoon to you. So first of all, the loan growth has come down. It's still at 35%, but just quarter on quarter, it's a 5-quarter low. So if you could tell us if this is sort of intentional or is it just because the base is growing?
Yes, first of all, please relate it to our ongoing guidance of growing the advance between 30 and 35%, you know, and that is what we've been doing. In fact, it is at the upper end of that range, at 35%. So I would say that it is more than satisfactory. The second point here is that if you break down the loan growth, obviously the retail is growing faster than the wholesale. And if wholesale grows at in the high 20s, I think that again, the way the environment is today, is a pretty decent, you know, if I may say, rate of growth. So just on that alone, I would say that we are pretty satisfied. When it comes to margins, two things have been trending for us for the last several quarters, and that has been very visible and transparent. One is that the business mix itself is gradually sort of moving towards, you know, more retail. So, you know, it was 40% retail and 60% wholesale, and now I think we are at 43% retail and 57% wholesale as of this quarter end. So, and retail obviously is growing faster, which includes cards, micro banking, LAP and others. And those are the faster growing businesses for us at the higher margins itself. So the margin effect is somewhat being driven from there. The second is that even as cost of funds has increased in the last, you know, 2 to 3 quarters, I think we've been able to successfully pass that on through our increases in MCLR, etc., on, you know, to the customers, and therefore at least protected margins on the wholesale businesses. So if you take that in combination, protecting margins in the wholesale business and actually containing credit costs also, therefore ensuring, you know, good profitability in, you know, there, and, you know, the, with the retail piece growing in proportion, leading to a consistent improvement in net interest margin.
Okay, Vishwavir, hi, good afternoon. Any exposure to the SL group, funded and non-funded?
Look, you know, to be frank, there is some exposure to some of the companies there. And this is something that sort of is a development of the weekend only. And but having said that, you know, we are very strong in terms of our risk underwriting standards, etc. And our quick look at some of these portfolios suggests that they've all been made in terms of the normal prudential lending standards of the bank based on operating cash flows and operating assets. And I don't, you know, at least at this moment, we don't see, we are quite satisfied with the way things are. And I think it's more the capital market side where, the, you know, the impact is coming at the moment. Let's see, let's watch this space.
Okay. A word on the slippages as well, sir. 7-quarter high slippages are coming in at over 200 crore rupees. There's also a big write-off. You've written off NPAs worth 103 crores versus just 65 crores last quarter. Can you just explain some of these trends to us, please?
So, you know, some part of it we've been explaining even earlier, that the actual quantum of slippage, not necessarily percentage, is obviously increasing because of the fast-growing card business that we have, where there are, you know, lot of upfront costs that you take, and also the way you provide, you know, in that business. So obviously that business is growing so fast that the quantums will start showing progressively higher. That's the first part. The second part is that we have taken a little higher provision in our agri portfolio. Again, on the agri side, because of the waivers and other things that have been going on in the environment, you know, for the last 12-18 months, we have been commenting on it, you know, in our announcements, that is a portfolio that has some stress, and we have pared down that portfolio to less than 3% of our book. So it's now a very minuscule amount, but in this quarter we took some provision there. Third part is that we have been increasing our PCR percentage, which is a prudential measure that we've been doing. Again, if you see, our PCR has moved up every quarter in the last four quarters. It is now at 63%. It was under 55% 9 months ago or something. So all these things add up to a slightly higher provisioning number. Having said that, our gross NPA is down, our net NPA is down. You know, our ROE is up, our ROA is up. These are well within our abilities, let me put it that way.
Okay. All right, Mr. Ahuja. We'll leave it on that note for this quarter. Thanks very much for joining in. So they do have exposure to the SL group, but they don't see any reason to worry about that exposure, at least as of now. RBL Bank down about 2% off numbers. Okay, we need to take a very quick break. We'll come back and keep focusing on the market on the other side. And also more earnings coming up. We will have the executive director of Canara Bank join in with the discussion on their third quarter performance.